Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And recently I was working in the fabric warehouse and I needed to create a timetable and a date table. And I have so many different ways that I've done it before, using looping and variable tables and temp tables, or using system tables that have lots and lots of rows. And I tried to do it and I was a little disappointed because none of those options were available. I was disappointed at first. I reached out to someone named Brad Schacht. Brad works on the fabric product team at Microsoft. And he was like, oh, you got to use this new function called GENERATESERIES. It's like, whoa, that's only supported in DAX. He was like, nope, it's supported in SQL. And so I went on a journey and I want to share that journey with you. So, you know how we like to do a Guy in the Cube? Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So first, this is the doc on GENERATESERIES. It's also supported by Azure SQL Database, Managed Instance, the Analytics Endpoint in Microsoft Fabric, and also the Warehouse in Microsoft Fabric. And that's where I'm at. So let's head over to the Warehouse, right? Let me show you how this function works. So I'm going to say select star from GENERATESERIES. It is a table value function, and I'm going to give it a start, an end, and an increment. So if I do that, and I click run, you can see that it gives me 1 through 10, because it's gonna give me this single column table with as many numbers as I specify from the beginning to the end. And how I increment, if I change the increment to 2, I'll get 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. If I started at 1 and go to 2, I'll get odd numbers. But you get how this works. And you may be thinking, Patrick, well, how did you use this to create a time and a date table? Well, let me show you. We'll keep this here because we're gonna reuse this. And what we're gonna do is, for the timetable, declare a variable. Start time. And let me fix this. So there's 1,400 and I think 40 minutes in a day. And I want to increment this by 1. So check it out. You'll see that I get 1,440 rows. There's 60 minutes and there's 24 hours in a day. So 24 times 60, I think, is 1,440. So, but what I want to do is I want to format this up because I want to return a table that contains specific time information down to the minute, right? And so now all I need to do is run this query. And what you're going to see is, here's my time key. Maybe I use that as to establish my relationship. Here's the actual time. Here's the hour. Here's the hour with, you know, AM, PM. Here's the minute. It, and then here's the AM, PM. All I did after that was I created a timetable. You see right here, I use a drop if exists, dim time SQL, that's what I called it. Declare, created my table, and then I just did an insert staple, insert into DBO, dim. And I run that and it populates my table. And I'll make sure that there's a link to this script in the description below. The date was a little more challenging because I needed to figure out where to start, where to end with leap years and things like that. So I had to get a little more creative. Let's go here. Let's clear most of this stuff out and we're going to go back to this. And so I need to figure out where to start and where to end. And so what I did was I declared a couple of variables, start, end, and an integer and another integer. You may be thinking, well, what's that for? And then what I did was, watch this. Let's just comment this out for now because we're going to need this later. I said select at start date, at end date, I said cast as int. And I did the same thing here, cast as int. And now if I run this, it takes both of those dates and converts them to integers, because under the covers, they're just integers anyway. And then what I did was, wait, let me show you. I thought this was pretty cool. So I'd say, give me this and assign that to that. And then give me this and assign that to that. And then right here, I just said at start int, at end int. That's what I did. And so we're gonna run this. And it went from the beginning. This is the numeric representation, or the integer representation, of January 1st, 2004. And if you go all the way to the end, way down here, you'll see the integer representation of December 31st. You can see it returns 366 rows. And so what I did from there was, I'm gonna paste this in and I'm gonna get rid of this insert just for now. And so what happens is, like, I declare my start and end, declare the integers, convert the date and times to integers, put those in a variable. And then I'm using a common table expression. I'm gonna need a semicolon. To run a common table expression, you must terminate it. And then I just run a query and do some conversions and it returns exactly what I need. So let me run this. And what you'll see is a complete date table. And you can get fancier. You can add fiscals and you can add holidays and you can add all these other different things to it. But this is the base. This is the foundation of how you can use this GENERATESERIES function in Fabric, which is amazing because it saved me so many clicks. Now I can use this GENERATESERIES function to not only build my dim timetable, but also build my dim date table. All right, what do you think? Any questions, comments? Did you know about this generate series? If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.